I'm Ron McDonald, and I'm a survivor of a cardiac arrest.
Recently, Fire Station Number 2 brought together doctors, firefighters, and paramedics to celebrate a second chance at life for three Edmond residents: Stephen Dudley, Richard Alsop, and Ron McDonald. All three suffered a full cardiac arrest, stopped breathing, and had no pulse. Edmond firefighters were able to revive them using a pilot program called neuro-protective CPR. When administering CPR on cardiac arrest victims, Edmond firefighters are trained to operate like a NASCAR pit crew. Each person has a specific job, and they work quickly and efficiently.
The cardiac arrest is probably one of the more intense calls. You know, it's already at its worst. You're just trying to improve the scenario, really. But whenever you get a cardiac arrest, it's all hands on deck. We do have a pit crew type system, so everybody has a role and knows what that role is prior to getting there. So it all kind of falls into place and we just get to work. There's not a lot of confusion. We just get to work.
First responders use state-of-the-art equipment like the rescue pod tool and a suction device called the rescue pump, both of which increase blood flow to the heart and brain. Double sequential defibrillation methods are also used to increase the amount of electricity the patient receives during a defibrillation. The newest addition to the CPR procedure is a device called EleGARD, which elevates the patient's head and thorax to 30 degrees over a period of 2 minutes. Recent discoveries have shown that this elevation technique increases blood flow and allows firefighters to treat the heart while protecting the brain. The combination of all these techniques has made a noticeable difference.
I can tell you, we've seen an increase in getting pulses back on patients in cardiac arrest that just historically we didn't see. We always had, I think, from local area, a good survival rate, but we are starting to see pulses with this bundle of care that we're doing a lot at a hot lot higher rate. And I can tell you, and I think the guys in back can vouch for it, we're having more and more survivors walk into the fire stations to introduce themselves that I've seen. So, you know, that's obviously a positive for our community. I think we're on the right track in that direction.
The EleGARD system was invented by Dr. Keith Lurie, who actually flew in from Minneapolis to visit the survivors, their families, and the first responders.
I am thrilled to be here today. So first, a really big thanks to Edmond Fire Department for having the courage and recognizing the need to change what we've done for 60 years and implement new approaches to cardiac arrest so we have more survivors.
Dr. Jeff Goodlow, the Oklahoma City and Tulsa Chief Medical Officer, first approached the Edmond Fire Department in 2021 to pitch the idea of using the EleGARD device during the initial response when seconds count.
We know that the biggest difference between life and death, we have got to get restoration of a pulse, of circulation, of breathing, before we get someone to the hospital. If we can do that, they have a far better chance, not just to survive, but to survive with the quality of life that you are clearly seeing here today.
Mayor Davis was also present to meet Dr. Lurie and the survivors. Firefighters demonstrated how they respond to a cardiac arrest and use all of the available resources to treat a patient when they arrive on the scene.
I'm very grateful for the firefighters, grateful to Dr. Lurie's machine, and the nurses at Oklahoma Hospital.
From everybody behind the scenes that made these decisions to get the equipment and to do the training, and then the firefighters themselves that came in and executed this, like, without all of those pieces in place and the passion involved and the commitment, I wouldn't be alive right now. Everything that happened to me here in Edmond is the reason that I've survived. And now physically, I'm in better condition than I ever was before. I managed to quit smoking. The coma made that pretty easy for me. But now, like, my heart conditioning in terms of like cardio and the weight training and stuff that I do, it just recovers way better than it ever did before. So a big thank you to everybody involved in that for making this happen, the neuroprotective CPR.
I can't give any more higher praise than it is to the Edmond Fire Department, who got there so quickly and then used the equipment that they did to help what I am assured gave me a great neurological outcome and had no deficits. So I appreciate them and will always remember what they've done for me.